appear to be good friends. People always saw them together. Yet they have never died at each other's houses. One day, Toad said to Grasshopper,
"Dear friend, tomorrow come and dine at my house. My wife and I will prepare a special meal. We will eat it together."
The next day, Grasshopper arrived in Toad's house. Before sitting down to eat, Toad washed his four legs and invited Grasshopper to do the same. Grasshopper did so, and it made a loud noise.
"Friend Grasshopper, can you leave your chirping behind? I cannot eat with such a noise,"
said Toad. Grasshopper tried to eat without rubbing his four legs together, but it was impossible. Each time he gave a chirp, Toad complained and asked him to be quiet. Grasshopper was angry and could not eat. Finally, he said to Toad,
"I invite you to my house for dinner tomorrow,"
said Grasshopper. The next day, Toad arrived at Grasshopper's room. As soon as the meal was ready, Grasshopper washed his four legs and invited Toad to do the same. Toad did so, and hopped toward the food.
"You had better go back and wash again,"
said Grasshopper.
"All the topping in the jar has made the four legs eat again. Go!"
Toad hopped back to the water jar, washed again, and then hopped back to the table and was ready to reach out some food from one of the platters when Grasshopper stopped him.
"Please don't put your dirty paws into the food. Go and wash them again."
Toad was furious.
"You just don't want me to eat with you," he cried. "You know very well that I must use my paws and four legs in hopping about. I cannot help it if they get a bit dirty between the water jar and the table."
"You are the one who started this today. You know I cannot rub my four legs without making a noise."
"You are really mean. Are you taking revenge to me?"
Toad criticized.
"No, I only want to show you how accepting others' weakness is very important."
But from then on, the Toad and Grasshopper were no